God is always with you. And we read from Judges chapter 7, beginning with verse 8. So Gideon sent the rest of the Israelites to their tents, but kept the 300 who took over the provisions and trumpets of the others. Now the camp of Midian lay below him in the valley. During that night, the Lord said to Gideon, "Get up, go down against the camp, because I'm going to give it into your hands. If you are afraid to attack, go down to the camp with your servant Purah and listen to what they are saying. Afterward, you will be encouraged to attack the camp." So he and Purah, his servant, went down to the outposts of the camp. The Midianites, the Amalekites, and all the other eastern peoples had settled in the valley, thick as locusts. Their camels could no more be counted than the sand on the seashore. Gideon arrived just as a man was telling a friend his dream. "I had a dream," he was saying. "A round loaf of barley bread came tumbling into the Midianite camp. It struck the tent with such force that the tent overturned and collapsed." His friend responded, "This can be nothing other than the sword of Gideon, son of Joash, the Israelite. God has given the Midianites and the whole camp into his hands." When Gideon heard the dream and its interpretation, he worshiped God. He returned to the camp of Israel and called out, "Get up! The Lord has given the Midianite camp into your hands." Dividing the 300 men into three companies, he placed trumpets and empty jars in the hands of all of them with torches inside. "Watch me," he told them. "Follow my lead. When I get to the edge of the camp, do exactly as I do. When I and all who are with me blow our trumpets, then turn all around the camp. Then from all around the camp, blow yours and shout for the Lord and for Gideon." Gideon and the 100 men were with him, reached the edge of the camp at the beginning of the middle watch, just after they had changed the guard. They blew their trumpets and broke the jars that were in their hands. The three companies blew the trumpets and smashed the jars. Grasping the torches in their left hands and holding in their right hands the trumpets they were to blow, they shouted, "A sword for the Lord and for Gideon." While each man held his position around the camp, all the Midianites ran, crying out as they fled. When the 300 trumpets sounded, the Lord caused the men throughout the camp to turn on each other with their swords. The army fled to Beth Shitta.
The word of our Lord.
My friends, maybe you remember what led up to our text. God's people, sadly, had fallen into the sins of the people whom they had replaced in the Holy Land. They were worshiping idols. So God allowed the enemies to come in, trying to teach his people to come back to the one true God. For 7 years, whenever they'd have a harvest, the Midianites would come in and take all the harvest for themselves. 7 years of that. Can you imagine having a tough time finding food for 7 years? Finally, the Lord called Gideon. Where was Gideon? He he was harvesting his crops in the wine press, trying to find a place to hide his food so the enemy wouldn't get it. Gideon accepted the call and gathered together an army. But when the Lord saw all the soldiers gathered together, he said, "Gideon, too many men. If I give you the victory with that many men, they're going to say they won the victory and not the Lord." So the Lord suggested, and Gideon carried it out, "Any man who's afraid, go ahead and go home." 22,000 men went back home. Then God says, "Gideon, you still have 10,000 men, still too many. Give them this test. There's the stream. Have them take a drink. And separate those who lie down and sip water from this stream from those who kneel and with their hands cup the water and lap the water up like a dog." 300 men knelt down and lapped the water like a dog. God said, "Those are the ones that you need. Send the other ones home." That's what Gideon did. So you heard the plan God gave to them. And my friends, I want you to see this plain. It is a huge plain. When I had the honor of visiting the Holy Land, I didn't have a special camera to take the whole spectrum. I had to take three pictures to get a picture of the whole plain. And the Bible told us what we just read is that this plain was filled with Midianites and all these enemy soldiers. And one couldn't even count the camels. There were as many as sand on the seashore. So hard to comprehend, isn't it, how these 300 men could get all the way around this huge area. But they did. And they followed Joshua's, or rather Gideon's, instructions. Blow that trumpet. Break that jar. Hold up the torch. Remember, this is the middle of the night. And it's just the change of the guard. So more people are awake to become terrified and waking everybody else up who don't wake up from the noise of the jar breaking and the trumpet sounding. So they get up and they see these lanterns all around them, and it sounds like a horde of an army to them. But of course, God is always with us, and he was with Gideon. So the enemy soldiers are thrown into confusion, and they start turning on one another, fighting and killing one another, and then they run. And the children of Israel can track them down, run after them, with the 300 men calling out 4 men as they go. God is always with us. What kind of challenges might you be struggling with in your lives? Might we be struggling with one idol or another? You know, sometimes people always can make time to watch their favorite sports team, but they can't always find time to read their Bibles. You might always find time to play, to enjoy yourselves, but we may not always have time enjoying, sharing with everybody the comfort and peace we have to know God is always with us. We are hard workers when we have jobs, or even in our volunteer work, we're always there. Are we just as conscientious when it comes to serving the Lord? Sometimes we all struggle with idols, don't we? So God's promise, though, to us is, be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged. For the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. How can a holy God be with us when we sometimes have those idols crop up in our lives? Yes, our awesome God wanted to be with us every step of the way, and that's why Jesus came, to conquer our worst enemies, sin, death, and the devil. And he proved it by dying on that cross and rising again, so we can be certain God is always with us. That's what gives us courage, dear friends, as we may face challenges that we might, humanly speaking, think, no way can I do this. God is with us. He's always with us. I was impressed by one young man I was talking to recently. He just graduated from high school. And here, he's been blessed with a job. His grandfather helped him find a cabin on the river where he can pay his own rent, learn independence. And how did he summarize these blessings? He didn't say, I was lucky. He said, God was with me. God is always with us. We can't lose. Let's praise him with the last four verses of hymn 419. With God himself before me,